In this video, I'm going to show you how I edit my night photography, how I take something that looks like this into something that looks like this, as well as a couple other examples of photos I've taken in recent videos on this channel, starting with a photo of a car that I took just a couple of weeks ago in Dubai on a foggy morning. So we're going to start the edit with a crop, getting a wider screen angle and getting our subject into the middle. This is just personal preference, obviously. And then we're going to start the edit by actually lowering the contrast so that we can increase the dynamic range. Then turn up the highlights and shadows just a little bit. Shadows so that we can reveal even more. And tuning up the whites in order to increase highlight contrast without losing the details too much. Then moving on to the curve. On this edit, we want to keep the blacks very black. Slightly drop the shadows and play with the mid-tones just a little bit and increase the highlights a little bit more, regaining the contrast, but in a different way. And what I really like to do for foggy photos especially is to further exaggerate the fogginess by decreasing our dehaze and clarity by an amount that feels right, because I like to start all of my edits by thinking about what exactly I like about this particular photo, and then the idea is to basically exaggerate that while also just playing around and seeing what might work. Adding some vignette to kind of further increase the contrast on the edges without losing the details in the middle of the photo, which is our main subject. And then we're going to start playing with the colors. Here it's very subjective which color you want to use. I went for a slightly purple tint for this particular photo and then went on to play with the individual colors just a little bit. Here the blues, mostly the highlights from those street lights, increasing the luminance, actually decreasing the luminance, and then the oranges, just a slight change, not really necessary for this photo. I think I might have copied that over from another edit in the same series, but I'm just recreating this for you guys. Often I'm not sure why exactly I did every single step, so it's always a little bit different or difficult to recreate the edits. Anyway, and now we're going to the color creating part, meaning adding some additional color into the shadows, taking a bluish, slightly purplish, purple-ish shade of blue, but this is somewhere you can play around a lot. I feel for this image, also going for the greener side would work just as well. It just depends on which mood you want to do. And then the final touch is exaggerating the effect of the glass of the car, the back glass, and we're going to add a radial filter onto that, because we've removed a lot of detail by removing the dehaze and the clarity, but now we're going to add it to just this part of the photo so you can see some of the water on the back of the car and some of the details on the window, which adds focus to that part and just really draws our eyes into it and exaggerates the interesting detail that makes it look like there's maybe a zombie inside of this car, like I said on the previous video where I actually took this photo. And now my editing method is usually involves taking a small break and then coming back and further fine-tuning the image, which I chose to do here as well, and that is pretty much a recreation of the edit. We could maybe make it just a little bit more contrasty. But anyway, moving on to the next photo, and this one is gonna be a quick one. Not the type of an edit that I usually do, but I like the style of this photo. And this photo is also from a recent video I did with the Ricoh GR3 walking around in Dubai. And some of you were curious about these edits, so here we go. At its core, this edit is gonna be fairly similar to the previous one, but just a much more simple version of that. So we're just gonna do a crop here just to get a more central composition and crop out a couple of distracting details. And then we're just gonna go crazy with the temperature, going very blue, but putting the tint more into the green direction this time. And then doing again the same thing as earlier, actually decreasing the contrast to get a higher dynamic range. The curve for this one is going to be very, very simple. Just a slightly lifted up black point and a bit of a shadow contrast, and that is all. Very, very subtle lifted black point there. And then we're going to go and give this pretty much a fake promise filter look with decreased clarity and dehaze. And that's pretty much it. Fine-tuning the crop a little bit because I forgot to crop out the thing on the left. Probably the simplest edit that I ever done that I actually like, but it gives us this kind of lo-fi cold blue look. By the way, the decreasing contrasting is not only to get a higher dynamic range, but it's to get this kind of a, you know, just generally lower contrasty lo-fi look. Because if I only wanted to increase the dynamic range, I could obviously just lift up the shadows and decrease the highlights, but I don't know what exactly I was saying there. The last edit is going to be the most complicated edit out of all of these, but we are still using a similar technique and philosophy for this edit. I think the only difference is it took me like 4 or 5 rounds of edits to actually arrive at the end result here. Because what I often do is I edit an entire batch of photos from the same day from similar conditions, and then I copy and paste some of the settings and play around and adjust each individual edit to each individual photo. So these edits aren't completely authentic recreations because I don't actually do it from scratch for every single photo, but hopefully it gets the point across. Anyway, the same start, doing the crop and the exposure, you get the point. Moving on to the tone curve, I'll lift the black point, darkening the shadows, slight adjustment in the midpoint there, then going over to the highlights, revealing some highlight detail, but keeping the contrast up by increasing the whites, then revealing some shadow detail, and again, a very slight decrease of contrast. Adjusting the tone curve further just a little bit here. In reality, there's tons of these micro adjustments all throughout the process. Then going for the temperature, trying to reveal those blues by decreasing the temperature, making it colder, slight adjustment of tint, and actually turning down the white brands a little bit, making it not too colorful. But the real purpose of adjusting the color temperature there was to play with the individual colors, making the blues more teal is a thing that I like to do often, and then increasing the luminance, getting more, actually less color for the blues, making it stand out there in the middle, and a slight decrease of saturation on the blues. Then the opposite color, the orange, changing the hue a little bit again, and actually pumping up the saturation because there's not that much orange in this photo, so we can get away with quite a lot of additional saturation for that particular color without getting too ridiculous. Then the color grading, we're actually gonna add some additional purplish blue onto the shadows here. Not super purplish actually, just blue. And then we're actually gonna play with the highlight grade as well, adding a greenish tint into the, you can see the higher part of the image with the highlight there, about there. And I think next we're gonna move on to, again, exaggerating the glow, making it less clear with decreased clarity and dehaze, a thing we did in all three photos. It's not a thing that I do for every single one of my photos, but these three were pretty similar stylistically. Again, playing with the vignette and adding a little bit of grain. Now that we've done this part, we can play around further with some fine-tuning adjustments of the contrast and the tone curve again, just to get it to look exactly right. This is often part of the process, which in reality will take like, you know, several hours, not several hours, but like several different editing sessions to try to get the look right, and also to try to get some consistency on all of the photos that I took on that particular day, because you don't want to have too much of a difference between each individual edit. You want some sort of consistency, but essentially that is about done. Now before you go, like I mentioned, I think there's actually a lot more that goes into editing photos than, you know, the single individual edit. I have a whole entire process, an entire workflow for editing that involves, you know, several different editing rounds, an editing philosophy, music choices. So if you want to better understand my entire editing process, I recommend you check out this video that I made recently on just the topic of the workflow and the mindset and the philosophy behind coming up with better creative edits. And of course, all these photos were taken from my recent photography vlogs on this channel. So if you want to see the shooting process, how I actually took these photos, or if you're new to the channel, check out some of the other videos I have on this channel from those days as well. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope to see you in the future as well.